On this day, we make a new covenant with you, says Lumiere. Elebonia says, we will bestow the power of the spirits upon you. Thanks. I'd say we earned it then. Okay, I don't know if there's going to be any more battles. Okay, and the small heel. Close enough. Resave. There is no way to go up from the bottom, unfortunately. Excellent. Anything else to see in this chamber? No. Wait, are we heading back? I mean, we didn't get anything, right? Maybe a way is open now that wasn't before? Oh. Neato. Gotta check that out. Let me just see what's anything else. Not completely sure what changed or if this is a different water chamber than we were in before. Alright, never mind. Let's get that thing then. That's all that seems to be in here. Is this. The resonant stone of spirit. Spirit is carved on it, says McBain. It looks like spirits from the past can be summoned with it. What does summon mean? Says Forte. He doesn't know the meaning of the word summon. Ada says, I guess it means they will just do stuff for you, like just like I control Pedro. Oh, we can summon the spirits to Ada. Yeah, that'd be great. I like that. Una says, so it means you've got more compelling allies, right? Something like that, says McBain. The voices of the spirits speak to you, as if from nowhere. The one who has gained all the ferocious powers, says Grantees. Lumiere says, you must realize more blessings. The added strength, Naradea says. Aramage says, that is the power of resonance. Rafaria says, the sound of ensemble. Elebonia says, it's the emerging power. Forte says, ensemble. You don't know the word either, Forte. McBain says, it means that if the phrases from two ferocious resonance stones are played at the same time, a new power will be produced. The sign of the spirit's presence disappeared quietly. Well, we accomplished our mission. Let's get out of here. Chest is empty. Yes, we did. And I keep saving because we keep achieving things. So I wonder what's going to happen next. Where are we going next? All the way back? Past Oasis and all that? Well, once we leave the cave, they're probably going to talk about where they should be going next and check the map for the next resonance stone. It's been the routine so far. All right, so this is another water room than the one we had been in, I think. Or we're the same one, but we're just up higher on the top part. Oh, I hit that. All right. Tusk shell and lobster. Surprise the enemy. No idea how tough these things are. They're probably easy compared to what we were just fighting. I use a couple, one or two finishing moves, maybe. Missed the lobster. So these are all at full strength. Maybe the lobsters are harder. Yeah, he can target the lobster. He just barely punch it. Someone's probably gonna knock it away and he won't be able to reach. Yeah, I'm interrupting that. Nice. All right. So we hit Tusk Shell B, I guess. And A. Oh, these are easier. Get this one. Yeah, that one came up out of nowhere. Just like before, but I had forgotten. Wait, oh. I didn't even see that one standing there. It's like, I'm insulted! And then dies. Fred leveling up to 29. Nice. Why is he leveled up? Why is he higher than the rest of us? It's not fair. Well, that was a thing. Let's try to find out. Well, we came from, I go the wrong way. This is like a side chamber or something. Did I? Monstre. Maybe we're supposed to head this way? Oh, my kingdom for a mini-map. I'm telling you. It's gotta be the way out, though. Right? But I came from here, right? Do I move across to the other? Good, 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 okay. Yes, I know what to do. We broke them all. We're a bunch of vandals. I hear water from the Grim Bridge. We were able to hear that from in here before? Yeah, I guess so. Forte says, now we've got all the resonance stones of Astern. McBain says, finally the time has come to go to Numeros Empire. Capri, says Ada, just hang in there and wait for us. Fred says, the main port of Numeros is Gezaug, but it's possible that no ferry boat is running since the war has started. I don't know, says Forte. Well, we won't know until we go there, says McBain. First, let's head to the port of Ened. Door closed. I won't say it scared me. It was more like a startling sound. I wasn't expecting a delayed close like that. I need to go to the port of Ened. Please direct me. Good luck on your tour. Oh, screw you then. I want to turn all these. I guess it's a good thing for everyone that I can't. Anything else to say? Anything else to say? No, okay. Well, we'll head back to the checkpoint and see the west checkpoint. See if anyone has can give any direction. Imagine how exhausting it would be to just walk all this. It's just a lot to get out of here. Anybody have anything new to say? All serene. I'm ready anytime the Numeros come to attack us, because there's no trash. It's because I don't want the first-time visitors to think that our country is dirty. That's funny. Let's see if any of these people have anything new to say. Why do you look so happy? Huh? Can you tell? Says McBain. No, this is not good. Sorry for being so insensitive when everyone is worried about the Numeros Army's move and Ostern's future. You're right, says Fred. The guide says, no, it's okay. Please be happy when there's something good. She's right, Mr. McBain. You have a tendency to worry about yourself too much around young ladies. So do you. Fort Ada says, I think one is bad as the other. I worry too much, says the guide, but when I see you guys being happy, I could restore a peace in my mind. Thank you. Okay. I'll make sure we beam extra loud for you. I heard that the Numeros soldiers are gathering at the port of Ened to the south. I wonder what they are thinking. Yeah. A lot of us want to know what they're thinking. I mean, we know what their intentions are. Well, not their exact plans for carrying them out, I don't think. Those store owners don't say anything, so. We just read all that last episode. Hi. What are we gonna do if the Numeros army come to attack? You know what? I'm going to practice hypnotism using this fire. But if there are so many of them, I would have to ask them to wait their turn. No, it's not realistic. What should I do? You try to hypnotize them. They gotta be in a relaxed state. What got here? Drums of oil or something? Well, I guess we're heading back in that direction. We'll so wait a second. This sign doesn't say anything, right? I'm looking for the port of Ened, but I'm sure it's got to be past Oasis. They make us run back and forth like this. Forte's poor feet just can't do anymore. I know the sand is soft, but he's got corns, you know. He can't be walking around like all over the whole freaking country like this. Well, let that thing sleep. Let that thing float. Ba-da-da-da-da. It's a jaunty jig. Everyone dance. I ran into that. It ran in front of me. Cactus and Caracallum. I remember these things being kind of annoying. Oh, I never healed Chan up to full. I swear, I'm not meaning to hit these things, so... If you guys like the combat, then here's a little combat. One down. Good, we need to hit that one. Caracallan A. It looks like a Wookiee or something. Dog heal self. Click click. I don't know if I want to use there. I'll use one. Because, I mean, Forte is halfway to getting it again anyway, so... bloop! That was not a worthwhile battle. Who needs a little lifey healy? Fred says, but still, I'm exhausted by going back and forth across the desert. Yes. Talk to Forte's corns about that. Oomph, you're so beat up. Are you really a con man? Says Ada. I don't think it has anything to do with this case, says Forte. Anyway, says Ada, it's not the time to show the white feather before we face the Numeros Army. You're so powerful, Ada. Says Fred. How can you always be so energetic? The monster drinks. McBain says, she was pretty dead when we arrived at Ostern, though. Pretty dead? Because I'm still young, says Ada. Says McBain. Fred says, I have no word in response to that. You had a few words in response. Come on, let's go, says Ada. Let's hurry back to the Oasis and head for Ened. Okay, so it's off of Oasis. Alrighty, says Fred. Yeah, that makes sense, because I think south of Oasis was the giraffe village. Right, and I think the port of Ened then is to the west from Oasis. It's all coming back to me. I knew in time it would... My god, what? I was trying to go around it, and it just ran in front. You guys all saw that. I don't want to use any power meters, finishing moves on these. I'm gonna shoot! Shot the wrong one. That's right, we destroyed the original one. So now they attack whatever they feel like. Not sure if this one was hit, but Una hit this one, so let's get C. Someone might have hit this one, I'm not sure. I can only go by what I know. I think someone had hit it. We can rest at Oasis. That's true. We need our magic restored. Ada says, what? What's going on now? Everyone's gone except for one person? Oh, there's one person at the bottom? Oh, those street vendors just are gone. Una says there's no one attending the street stalls. What's going on with everyone? Let's ask her. Shum says, my dream is to sleep on a bed of fruits laid all over it. I bet chili fruity smell will be the best. Okay. Oh, hello. I bet the Shanoon's dance would attract the people come to the bazaar. But the people in Selbart consider dancing and music performance as a part of the ascetic training, so odds are they will not do it. Oh. Oops. Didn't mean to hit that the third time. Bye-bye. Alright, so we walked forward from here, so... Well, that vendor's still there. I think this guy doesn't talk. No. No. And no to coming again. He's the item seller. He's not gonna talk either. Weapon shop. Is that the same one? Yep. Fruit, crazy fruit lady. Well, there's fruit over here, and there's no vendor here, so you can just take whatever you want, right? And just put him on a bed and just lay and go to sleep. And wake up with an apple stuck in your armpit. Alright, so I know I'm walking back and forth. I'm just trying to be thorough. Right, okay, Ened is south, that's great. Selbart is west. And I believe we've been to Selbart. And all these people, there's a big meeting apparently. Where's, it's over here, right? His old house. Yeah, alright. Huh. It's like it's not on the ground. It looks like it's not on the ground. It's above the ground, like sticking out, still attached to the building somehow. But it's not. Alright, let's talk to all these people. The jeweler says, I have a bad feeling. Maybe I'd better close the store soon. Bad feeling? Cloth shop guy says, I saw an old man with a black robe on among the soldiers. I would say they were just a dubious group. Antique dealer says, I saw the soldiers walking towards Selbart, accompanied by wooden monsters. I'm curious about how the dolls are made to work. You can ask Ada about that. Stall? It looks like those who just passed through here came from the port of Ened. They must be foreigners. The fruit dealer says, I can't believe there are people who walk on the desert road with armor on. Like us? Why do they want to look cool? It's much easier for the soldiers to walk with lighter clothes on. And they're not protected then. We have armor on. peddler says, I recognize those soldiers from somewhere. Now that I've taken the trouble to get items, the things around here are getting imminent. Spelled incorrectly. The trader says, I don't know what's going on, but it feels much hotter if so many people gather at one place like this. Body heat, yeah. Uni says, Fred, big news. The Numeros soldiers are heading for Selbart. They're also bringing their wooden soldiers along. Oh no, says Una. What are they going to do, Grandpa? We're going to hurry to Selbart. Fred says, Boss, I decided to go along with the McBain company. Huh? Are you still going to come with us? Says Ada. I'm a righteous con man. I can't leave bad people alone. I don't think the word righteous and con man go together, says Ada. You have a point, says Fred. I'll think about it. Anyway, as long as I have come this far, it's natural that I should feel anxious to find out what's going to happen, right? Good idea, says Garton. Help Mac out. I'm counting on you, Fred, says Garton. Aye, sir. Be careful, all. Those soldiers look strong. So I guess I actually spoke to both of them anyway. I was afraid that if I talked to him, something like a cutscene might happen. Because we gotta go rest in that inn first. I wonder what the Numeros Army needs in Selbart. Fresh corpses for the slaughter. That's what they need. I come behind the counter. Oh, if you're looking for a place to stay for a night, please come around the counter. Yes. Thank you very much. Full mana and we can go. So we're going to Selbart instead. So if we try to go to Ened. The following line is produced. Oh. Nope. It just lets us go to Ened. That's interesting. But Grandpa Mac has changed his mind. We want to go to Selbart to go help them. Hi, Fred. I haven't seen you at the bar lately. I'm sorry. I had to go to Selbart to take care of many things, but come visit us at the bar again. I'll treat you to a glass of lemonade. Hey, you're putting in a plug for the bar. Fred, the boss will fire you if you keep skipping your job like that. Yeah, I remember that exchange. Okay. Selbart is this way. And I'm going to call it an episode here. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next one. And always, seek adventure.